Welcome back. Hope you're doing okay and following along. If you have any questions, feel free to let me know. So let's get cracking. Okay, so I'm going to be mixing my grays base, and I'm using Cotman's Prussian blue, getting it activated with my brush. This is probably a boring part, but it's necessary. As you can see, I still need to do something about this palette. Roughen it up a little bit. Use some toothpaste or a sponge. Otherwise, you see what's happening here as it's beating up. Getting some more water, activating the Prussian blue. Boring stuff, but part of the process. If you want to learn, sometimes you just gotta watch and be bored, or fascinating if you're new to it. I'm always fascinating watching myself, not me myself, but watching other people. I guess it's no different from the kids today who are watching other people play video games because they're professionals. Which I find funny and ironic at the same time. Instead of playing the games, they're watching somebody like we're watching somebody right now. Mix and activate paint. Go figure. Alright, this is a good start. And then I'm going to use a tube, Payne's Gray, and this is Daniel Smith Extra Fine Watercolor. Don't need a lot. Well, forgot about that. You're going to have a bit of an oil binder stuff at the top, so just kind of squeeze that off. It's gonna be there. Don't want to waste too much paint as we go for this part, but anyway. So I'll get some water. Gonna mix a nice gray neutral tone. You can see, I wish I took care of this a little better. This is going to be my gray palette spot. Yeah, I'm not liking how it's beating up like this. Sorry. I'm going to move this over to the corner. So, I think you can see, let me slide this over a little bit more. All I'm doing is just adding more water to this side. I'm going to leave this my lighter washes. And I'm going to rinse this brush off a little bit. That sneeze you heard was my cat, Dory, sitting on my backside, wondering what I'm doing and pushing on my paper. As you can see, it's sliding. I'm adding a little more Prussian blue to the overall mix. More water. And bringing the Prussian blue over to this side. there, but should be good. Okay, so I've got a sufficient amount of wash to start with, and I'm going to do my plus my little sample pad, piece of paper. So, got my sample, or test paper, and I'm just going to see how it's going to flow on. All right. That's good. So, gonna add a little more of this to that. I want to start off light. See the difference here? Because I added a little bit more of my base to my watered down version, but I like a little bit of an in between, so. And with watercolor, you're basically just doing that by adding more water. Which I will do to this. There, so that's just my tonals. Getting water, going to here. And on this little pup, he's got some grays in here. I'll put down a little base coat. Actually, and to switch brushes. Oh, that's the beauty. So when you do rinse off a brush, dry it on a paper towel, especially one of these guys, and get a point so that it dries in the shape that it's supposed to be. And then you can, I've got a brush stand on the side. I'll stand it up there, going to this little brush, and there's fur on it. All right. So I'm just going to come in here, add the grays, the base, see how it dried lighter. And it's picking up some of the sepia that I put in, but that's okay. That's what I was intending to happen. And the beauty of using this wisp brush is you pick up, you'll see it's leaving little brush strokes that look like fur strokes. And that's a good thing. And brushing into the other color that I put on earlier, before this was dried, ties it all together. And with have some of the shadow color. I'm going to come in here, add it to where it needs to be, just because it happens to be on my brush. You got to be careful when you do that, because it will reactivate the paint that's underneath. So, just be careful. He's got a bunch of grays going over here. There's a bit of a white spot there from my reference. Try and brush into the motion of the fur. Some of this you can blend out when you go back to it, so it's not too bad, but you want to get a little dark here because there is a dark patch here. Alright, up into the air. Again, see how it's drying lighter. Shadow spots going over here. And the beauty with watercolor is if you get a little too dark in some spots, when it is dry or even when it's still wet, you can come back and pull some of that color out. I usually try and wait till it's dry, because it does dry lighter. I'm just going to throw a little bit of dark on the nose. Get that started, the darker tones. His owner reminded me that he's got a jet black nose. Or wanted to make sure of that. That's a little darker than I wanted. And when you do lift like that, some cat fur or dog fur, you want to be careful that you don't lift too much of what's already down there. You can see that happening right here, but that's okay. I wanted that to happen. And fur again. The pain is real. In. There we go. So I'm going to blend this out a little bit more. So I'm cleaning my brush with some clean water and just see how lightly touch it. You blend it in, reactivate it, and then you can dab it. And I'm going to go back in there, create some dark fur, blend it out. That'll get fixed up here when I go into the finals, the details. Again, you're just adding a base right now. This will dry lighter. Water, because I'm coming over here, flipping it around, See how it's picking up the sepia right in here. Again, that's what I was anticipating and wanting. Follow the hairline for growth. It's another reason I use the sepia underneath. It allows me to remember where the fur was flowing in the reference photo. Letting it come into a dry brush down below. Spinning it back over. Tying it all together right there. Just what I like about the Wisp brush is you can go into your under the blend spots where you need to blend and pull up and give that, or in, and keep that hair fur motion. All right, I'm gonna go really light here. Just enough. Add a little bit of a tone to this section because that is lighter parts of the ear with the light shining through from behind. This all is going to be dark fur, but I'm putting a base under there. Because when you pull the brush through on the darks, you want some undertone. This is okay. Doing some lighter shadows under his snout. It's all about layering. Again, I mentioned that. Layers, shadows, volume helps make things pop. Getting really wet over here. Get some shadows under the white. I'll be readdressing these shadows on a separate time. Bring this out, blend it in a little bit more. Be careful when you dab out. There we go. And let this dry and then come back to it. Again, that's a lot of what you're doing with watercolor. You want to make sure things are dry. At least I do with my style. Dry between layers. So you're less likely to lift up the stuff from underneath. And then you can see where you need to go back. Okay, we'll call this a pause point. Rinsing off my brush and pulling it from the ferrule out to keep the shape. Let that sucker sit there and dry. Thank you. Okay, let's get to it again. Up on the back, we've got some darks. You pull down some other colors that I'll be opening up. Back to the paint, just putting in some background, just putting in some shadowing where there's some black. It's a little more blue than I wanted. Let's go into the sepia. Grab some more. I'm going to grab some sepia and add that to it. There we go. Some Payne's gray. There. Okay. I'm just going to make a little darker tone overall. Nice swatch, and that's good. I'm okay with that. Go over this a little bit. It'll dry darker on this here, because that's where I'm putting some darks. This spot here is dark, so I'm going to add a little more. That will set the foreground further in, bring it closer to us. Here is a swath of dark fur that comes down. I'm looking at my reference. You'll see the reference will be in the corner. I'll start adding some of the darks, darker shadowing and fur. Make sure you don't put your hand into the paint. I'll be building up the nose as we go, but that's good for now. Get some darks in here. A little bit of dry brush, as you can hear. This little dab here is Payne's Gray. You'll see I keep going into it a little bit, pulling out just a dab here and there. A little darker than I want right now, but add a little bit of water and you can smooth it out, blend it in. Just pulling it all together. Adding darks here and there. Again, it's all about layers. The more layers you put on, the darker it'll get. So we're just building layers. Some more sepia. I'm looking at the reference photo and trying to determine where some darks are needed to pull everything in. Using the Wisp brush again, following the fur. Now I'm holding the brush a little higher, using the wispy parts, making sure those connect, which will give you the strands of fur that you're starting to see pop out. Yeah, easy in the background here, making noise, subtle noises. So if you hear any noises, it's her walking around, or as dogs do, licking themselves. Yeah, because it's okay that I'm recording. You'll see things starting to pop as you put in more contrast. I'm going to let these areas dry a little bit more, but meanwhile, come in here and work on the volume of this snout. Get the that to pop a little bit more. So what I did is I wet it down a little bit because it wasn't blending as well as I wanted it to. And then I dropped some color in, so now you'll see that it's blending a little better. That's the time to let that area dry. Just playing with the nose area a bit, adding a little more dark. So when it dries, I'll know how and what to do next. I'm going to add a little more water to this one. This here is not white, it's kind of a gray tone, tint, light. So that's what I'm going to bring out. There. When you see a harsh line pop up in the drying stage, you can slowly scumble it out. Let it dry. See what happens and go from there. Okay. That's it for now. Letting it dry.